हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम तृप्ति पंड्या एंड टुडे आई विल बी टीचिंग यू एलिमेंट ऑफ अकाउंट स्टैंडर्ड 11 पार्ट 2 चैप्टर 5 फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट ऑफ अ बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड अप टू इल्यूस्ट्रेशन नंबर 26. टुडे लेट अस स्टार्ट इल्यूस्ट्रेशन नंबर 27. Prepare final accounts from the following trial balance as on 31st March 2015 of Pushpa. First of all, trial balance of Pushpa as on 31st March 2015. Name of account and debit and credit here is given. Drawing and capital. We know that debit drawing and capital credit 24,003 lakh. Purchase and sales, purchase debit, sales credit, 2,96,008 lakh. Goods return, debit and credit both are there. Goods return debit means sales return, and good return credit means purchase return. Provident fund contribution to provident fund. Contribution to provision fund is 10,000 and 1 lakh is the provident fund. Provident fund investment, interest on provident fund investment. Provident fund investment is debit and interest is credit. Debtors and creditor. Debtors debit and creditors credit. 2 lakh and 1,50,000. Discount. Discount allowed then debit and discount received then credit. Bad debt. Bad debt reserve. Bad debt 30,000 debit and bad debt reserve 45,000 is there. Bills receivable. Bills payable. Bills receivable debit and bills payable credit. 15,000 and 25,000. Goods of stock 1,42,040. It is a opening stock 80,000. Damage 3,000. Tolai 1,000. These all are expenses. Carriage inward 18,000. Trade expense 90,000. Cash balance 16,000. It is always debit balance. Current asset is there. Bank balance 25,000. It is also debit balance. Fixed asset cost price is given 5 lakh and mark book value is given 4 lakh. So here 5 lakh and 4 lakh difference is there. This is the hidden adjustment. Advertisement expense 28,000. Now, another information as per the adjustment. So first, stock as on 31st March 2015 is 2 lakh, out of which market value of 30% stock is 20% more. When more word is there, then calculation is not necessary because our slogan is there. From market value and book value, whichever is less, we have to accept. So more value calculation is not necessary. Market value of a 50% stock is less. Calculation is necessary because less value is there, 10%. Whereas remaining stock needed to repair expense of 2000. So here we have to make the total value in 30%, 50% and 20%. This way three parts we distributed the 2 lakh distributed in 30%, 50% and 20%. And afterward we have to calculate the value. Goods of 5,000 given as advertisement. Here when advertisement expense is given, we have to minus from the purchase and add in advertisement expense. Credit sales of 10,000 wrongly recorded as a credit purchase. So in a from the credit purchase minus and add in a credit sale. So debtors and creditors also affected. Write off 20,000 as a bad debt from debtors. So here bad debt is given 20,000 and 10% bad debt reserve is also there. So we have to make the in profit and loss account from format of a trial balance, adjustment and trial balance. Calculate 10% interest in capital, add in capital and profit and loss account debit side. Interest on drawing, add in drawing and write in profit and loss account debit side. Calculate depreciation 10% on fixed asset as per straight line method. Depreciation minus from the fixed asset and write it is an expense, so 10% on profit and loss account. First of all, we prepare the trading account. We know that in a trading account, first of all, debit side, we have to write the opening stock, afterward purchase, minus wrongly recorded purchase, goods given for advertisement and purchase return. So first of all, we write the purchase 2,96,000, which is given in our trial balance, wrongly recorded purchase, it is given in an adjustment, first entry here. 2,96,000 minus 10,000, then 2,86,000. And the goods given for advertisement, 5,000. 2,86,000 minus 5,000 and minus purchase return 20,000. So total 2,61,000 is there. Damage expense is there 3,000. Toll 1,000. Carriage inward 18,000. Now credit side 8,00,000 plus unrecorded sales 10,000. 8,00,000 10,000 minus sales return 80,000. Outer column 7,00,000 30,000. And working not, we have to first of all we calculate the closing stock. For closing stock, it is given 30% by 50% and remaining 20%. 30%, 2,00,000, 30% we have to write as it is 60,000. 50% means 1,00,000. And 1,00,000, 10% less. So 1,00,000 minus 10%. So 90,000 is there. 1,00,000, 10%. So 10,000 is there. And 1,00,000 minus 10,000 is equal to 90,000 is there. And remaining 40,000, 2,000 is expense is there. So 38,000. So 90,000, 38,000 and 60,000. Then 1,88,000 is the closing stock. So in trading account, we have to write the closing stock 1,88,000 as per our working note. So now 7,30,000 plus 1,88,000, then 9,18,000 is there. And all the debit sides, all the expenses minus from 9,18,000, then difference amount is 5,55,000. It is to gross profit, transfer to profit and loss account. Now profit and loss account, all the expenses we have to write the debit side and all the incomes we have to write the credit side. Gross profit, first of all, we transfer here. Trading accounts, gross profit, we write here. Credit side of profit and loss account, 5,55,000 gross profit transferred from trading account. If any income is there, then we have to write here. Discount received 14,000 and interest on drawing 1,200. Now all the expenses we have to write here. Administrative expense to contribute provident fund 10,000, trade expense 90,000. Sales and distribution expense, discount given 46,000. Advertisement expense 28,000 plus. As per the adjustment, good given as advertisement 5,000. So here also we have to add the 5,000. 28,000 plus 5,000, then 33,000. Financial expense to interest on capital 30,000. Other expense and losses, bad debt reserve account, bad debt trial balance 30,000, bad debt adjustment 20,000, bad debt reserve 19,000. Total 69,000. TAAT format is there. Minus bad debt reserve as per the trial balance 45,000. 69,000 minus 45,000, outer column 24,000. To depreciation on fixed asset 50,000. Now total of a credit side is 5,70,200 and all the expenses we minus from this 5,70,200, then difference we get 2,87,200 and it is a not net profit we transfer to capital account. To net profit to capital account. Now we prepare the balance sheet. Balance sheet of a Puspa on 31st March 2015. It is a statement, not an account. So liability side, we have to write the first capital, which is given in trial balance 3,00,000 plus interest on capital 30,000 plus net profit we transfer from the profit and loss account 2,87,200. Total 6,17,200 minus drawing given in our trial balance 24,000 plus interest on drawing 1,200. Outer column 25,200. 6,17,200 minus 25,200. So we get 5,92,000. Non-current liability. Current liability provident fund 1,00,000 plus interest on provident fund investment 8,000. Total 1,08,000. Bills payable 25,000. Creditors 1,50,000 minus wrongly recorded purchase 10,000. 1,40,000. Now, here we have to write the in asset side non-current asset. Fixed asset 4,00,000 minus depreciation 50,000. Cost price 5,00,000 into 10%. So 3,50,000. Always when there is a cost price is there, on cost price we have to calculate the depreciation. Investment, provident fund investment 1,00,000. Current asset, debtors 2,00,000 plus unrecorded sales 10,000. 2,10,000 minus bad debt. As per the adjustment unrecorded sale, we have to add in a debtors. Minus bad debt 20,000. 1,90,000. Bad debt reserve 10%. 19,000. So outer column 1,71,000. Bills receivable 15,000, cash balance 16,000 and bank balance 25,000, closing stock 1,88,000. Automatically asset and liability both are 8,65,000, both are identical. Market value of 30% stock is more, hence cost value will be considered. Market value of 50% stock is less, hence market value will be considered. 20% stock is required repairing, therefore repairing cost will be deducted from the stock value. So this way, question number 27 is over. Now, question number 28. Prepare final account of Nirmi Traders from the following trial balance as on 31st March 2015 and adjustment. ट्रायल बैलेंस ऑफ निर्मित ट्रेडर्स ऑन 31 मार्च 2015, कैपिटल 3 लाख, ड्रॉइंग 18,000, लैंड एंड बिल्डिंग 2 लाख, मशीनरी 1,40,000, फर्नीचर एंड फिक्सचर 25,000, लीज होल्ड बिल्डिंग 1/4 2014 to 5 years. हियर हिडन एडजस्टमेंट इज देयर, दिस 50,000 इज गिवन फॉर 5 years, सेल्स ऑफ 5 लाख, सो 50,000 डिवाइड बाय 5, देन 10,000 इज देयर फॉर 1 year. Purchase return 12,000, debtors 90,000, 12% loan from surgeon. Here date is given 1/10/2014. So when there is a interest on loan is there, it, we have to calculate from 10/11/12, 1, 2 and 3 for 6 months. And loan on interest, loan from surgeon 30,000 is there, and when we calculate the interest at that time 12% and 6 months is there. Purchase 2 lakh, sales return 10,000, freight 15,000, sundry expense 1,000. Stationery printing 2,500, insurance premium 14,200, bad debt 15,000, bad debt reserve 14,000, discount reserve on debtor 500, commission received 8,000, goods for stock 1/4 2014, opening stock 11,000, salary wages 54,000, creditors 30,000, dead stock 5,000, bank overdraft 21,000. Now cash balance 40,800, carriage inward 11,000, carriage outward 4,000, bills 18,000, debit and credit 10,000, discount allowed 1,000. Now adjustment, closing stock as on 31st March 2015 was valued at rupees 41,000. Fire occurred in business as on 31st January 2015, due to which goods of rupees 10,000 were destroyed and the insurance company accepted the claim of rupees 7,000. Here 10,000 minus 7,000, 3,000 loss is there. Out of debt, debtors 5,000 are not recoverable, so they are to be written off. Provide bad debt reserve 10% and discount reserve 2% on debtors. Nirmi withdraw goods of rupees 1,000 for personal use which are not recorded in the books of account. So drawing is not recorded. Credit purchase, so one entry from purchase and one entry from balance it add in drawing. Credit purchase of 5,000 were not recorded. When credit purchase not recorded at that time, add in a creditor and add in purchase. Calculate a depreciation 10% on land and building. So calculate depreciation, write profit and loss account debit side and minus from land and building. 20% on machinery, profit and loss account debit side and minus from machinery depreciation. 5% on furniture, furniture and fixture, minus this amount from furniture and fixture, and one entry right in profit and loss account debit side. Insurance premium included 1200 for next year, so here prepaid insurance is there. Commission of rupees 1000 receivable. Receivable is our asset is there, so balance it asset side and add in commission. Here trading account Nirmi Traders for the year ending 31st March 2015. First of all, we write the two opening stock 11,000. Purchase 2 lakh plus unrecorded purchase 5,000. 2 lakh 5,000 minus purchase return 12,000. 1 lakh 93,000. Goods burnt by fire 10,000. Withdrawn for personal use 1. Total 11,000. 1 lakh 93,000 minus 11,000. 1 lakh 82,000 is there. Freight 15,000. Carriage inward 11,000. Now credit side, sales 5 lakh minus sales return 10,000, 4 lakh 90,000 and closing stock 41,000. 5 lakh 31,000 minus all the expenses, then remaining difference is 3 lakh 12,000 gross profit transfer to profit and loss account. Now this 3 lakh 12,000 we transfer here, gross profit 3 lakh 12,000 profit and loss account of Nirmi Traders for the year ending 31st March 2015. Transfer from trading account by commission 8,000 plus receivable 1,000, total 9,000. Now sundry expenses 1,000, stationery printing 2,500, insurance premium 14,200 minus prepaid 1,200, total 13,000. To salary wages 54,000, sales distribution expense to carriage outward 4,000, financial expense to interest on loan 1,800, other expense and losses to be write off return of a leasehold building 10,000, bed debt trial balance 15,000, bed debt adjustment 5,000, bed debt reserve 8,500, total 28,500 minus bad debt reserve trial balance, it is 14,000. So TAAT format is that. Discount reserve on debtors, outer column 14,500. Discount reserve on debtors, discount given 1,000 plus discount reserve on debtors 1,530, total 2,530 minus discount reserve on debtors 500, outer column 2000 to 830, loss due to fire 3000, land and building 20000, machinery 28000, furniture fixer 1250, outer column 49250. Now credit side total is 3,21,000, and all the expenses we minus, then from 3,21,000, then difference arise 1,65,920. It is a net profit transferred to capital account. Now this net profit we transfer in a balance sheet. Balance sheet of a Nirmi Traders on 31st March 2015. Capital 3 lakh plus net profit 1,65,920. Transfer from profit and loss account total 4,65,920. Minus drawing 18,000 plus goods withdrawn for personal use 1,000. Total 19,000. Minus from here then 4,46,920. Non-current liability 12% surgeon's loan 30,000 plus interest on loan 1,831,800. 12% and 6 months loan, so 1,800 interest is there. Current liability 30,000 creditors plus unrecorded credit purchase 5,000. Outer column 35,000. Bank overdraft 21,000. Bills payable 10,000. Now asset side. There are non-current asset, fixed asset, land and building 2 lakh minus depreciation 10%, 20,000, outer column 1,80,000. Machinery 1,40,000, minus depreciation 20%, 28,000 and 1,12,000. Furniture and fixture 25,000, minus depreciation 5%, 1,250, 23,750. Leasehold building 50,000, minus right of 1/5, 10,000, outer column 40,000, dead stock 5,000, current asset, debtors 90,000 minus bad debt 5,000, 85,000 minus bad debt reserve 10%, 8,500, 76,500 minus discount reserve on debtor 2%, 1,530, outer column 74,970, cash balance 40,800, bills receivable 18,000, closing stock 41,000, insurance company account 7,000, prepaid insurance premium 1200 and commission receivable 1000. Total of both the side is 5,44,720. Now, outstanding interest on surgeon's loan. Loan was taken from surgeon as on 1/10/2014. Final account date 31st March 2015. Means unpaid interest on loan duration is 6 months. Interest 30,000 into 12% into 6 upon 12 is equal to 18 rupees. So, outstanding interest is 1800 rupees. Now, this way our question number 27 and 28 is over. Thank you very much.